travel the unusual open bridge in 1965 and held a state funeral for the fallen generals and a demonstration of the military's new dominance. The car on the train from the heading out of fear for its safety.
The president now has publicly backed new military leadership for appears to point to the heat of discredited, indeed apparently demonic September 30th movement. Defense Minister Scotia gives a passion speech, condemning the treachery of the communist rebellion, and recognizes the hard work leadership. Around the auditorium, a local chapter of the enemy's communist party participated in the festivities of their own blood, proudly waving their hammer and several flags alongside the military celebration. In Washington, D.C., the State Department received a cable from the U.S. Embassy in Jakarta on October 5th, signed by Ambassador Marshall Green, in which he outlined the situation. Following guidelines based upon policy and support of poverty in the state. A. Avoid overt involvement and power struggle in both. B. Covertly, however, indicate clearly key people in armies such as the Sudan and Sahara are desired to be of assistance where we can, while at the same time defending them our assumption that we should avoid appearance of involvement or interference in any way. C. Maintain and if possible extend our contract with military. D. Avoid moves that might be interpreted as known non-confidence in army. E. Start the story of PK as guilt, treachery, and brutality.